All right, in this video, we're going to go ahead and use the layout designer to finish customizing our purchase order template. So I'm going to click here on purchase orders, go up to the customize button, and click customize data layout. Okay, as you remember, we built this template a little bit earlier. We changed it to a landscape. One thing that I want to note is that when we added some headers here, notice how they're are in a different color. They're not in the blue scheme because they default to black. So I'm going to go ahead back to the basic customization, select the color scheme of blue and apply it so that those all turn to blue as well. Okay, so going in here to the layout designer, this is the grid edit format. All right, so we're going to go ahead and alter some of these looks. So I'm going to move these around. First of all, the most important thing, of course, my logo. I want that to look really nice and big. And for my purchase order, I'm going to put it right in the middle of the screen here. All right. Then I'm going to go ahead and put my company name over here in the corner, company information, and I'm going to shrink down this box. It doesn't really matter because it doesn't have borders, you can see. But I just want the boxes a little bit smaller there. If I wanted to, I could right-click and click on properties. All right, I could also click on properties up here and change the properties. Right now it's in blue. It's justifying to the left. If I wanted to put a border, I could. If I wanted to click on the font here, I can make it a strikeout or an underline. I could make it bold or bold italic, you know, so you have all these different choices, different fonts that you can use as well. Okay, go ahead and say okay there. Notice how it changes to bold, so it's a little bit bolder there. The purchase order, maybe I want to put this right down here in the middle, right under my QB Learning logo. The date and purchase order number, let's say I want to have this lined up like this here and over here. So if I wanted to, I can also copy the format of one box into another. So if I liked that this is bold, for example, and I wanted the rest of my information down here to be bold as well, I'm going to click on this box here, choose copy format, and then every box I click on from that point on is going to have the same formatting as the original box I checked. So I'm going to make my address bold, I'm going to make my PO number bold, and I'm going to make my date bold. Once I'm done, notice how it's a little paintbrush there icon. Once I'm done, I'm going to go ahead and say end format. So that way that paintbrush goes away, and when I click on other boxes, it doesn't transfer that format over. The other thing that you can do is, let's say that you wanted to have these boxes be the same size as these boxes up here. You can select, you click on one box, you press the shift key down, hold it down, click on another box, press the shift key down, hold it down, click on another box, because this is a box we want it to look like, and you click on size. Then it makes those boxes automatically the same size as the final one that you checked. All right, the vendor information down here. Again, notice that it gives you the little windows so that if you're folding these up, the information would fall into these boxes there. If you didn't like terms to be here, you could put your terms over here. If you wanted to put the ship via up top here, you could do that. Let's go ahead and drag these up here. Probably if you want them like this, you're also going to want to copy this format and make ship via the same format. Your expected date, let's say we want it over here a little bit again, and we want it to be larger. We want to really make sure that they notice those boxes. Then if I scroll down here to the bottom, I do have all the information, the manufacturer's part number, the description, item number, all that stuff. If I wanted to, if I don't like the word description, I can click on this and say item information field. So you can rename any of these to be whatever you would like them. Instead of item, if you wanted to call it tools, okay, you could rename it. Instead of manufacturer MPN, you could name it part number. All right, so you can change those about as much as you want to. You have your total box down here. If you'd prefer the total to fall further down on the screen, make sure and move both the actual total box as well as the sum. You can add additional fields if you want to. Add some text boxes, add a data field. So you can add any of these different data fields here. Okay. Vendor contact information, vendor phone number, website, your website. Okay, so you can add all that information here. I'm going to remove those. One of the things that's really nice in QuickBooks with this layout designer is that you also have the undo key. Everybody likes that undo key. I'm going to remove this for now, and I'm going to go ahead and add a text box of my own. Notice that you can, add additional information here. You can select the font, border, background, and it's whatever information you want to put in that text box. So this is also a great way to add a disclaimer. Okay. So once this is done being customized, we can go ahead and say okay. All right. And that's what it's going to look like when it prints out. We do a little print preview. Notice it's still landscaped. Everything's the same size. It says part number, study manufacturer's part number, tools, item information field. Okay, so all those changes held up for us there, and we've customized our purchase order.